and is a man that's got a decent record here, but it's not compared with Austin or the Saxon Ring, is it, for the championship leader?
Yeah, just straight away feeding back information to crew chief Santi Hernandez about what he feels track conditions are like right now. We're still 16 minutes away from the get-go here in Brno. Second from pole here in 2011, Marquez in Moto2. He won Moto2 in 2012. MotoGP winner in that outstanding and historic first year in 2013. Fourth from pole in 2014, second 2 years ago, and third from pole last year as well.
Well, guys, let's get some first-hand information on track conditions down here with Jack Miller. Jack, I'm sure a frustrating situation for you guys. You've been out there now. What's it like? Do you reckon wet enough for the softs, or do you reckon you can go with the mediums?
No, I put a soft on this morning and really, really, really struggled. We've had two problems with the tyres so far, both wet sessions. I mean, you know, me normally I go quite well in the wet, but I've been really struggling. And yeah, this morning I tried to run with the soft, and on the lap out of the box was the last three sectors were my best three sectors. After that, it just got worse and worse and worse. And yeah, after six laps, the tyre delaminated. So definitely won't be going on the soft option. We'll put it on the rear, the hard on the rear. But soft on the front seems to be working pretty good. Like I said, you know, I did a lot of laps on it this morning and it looked brand new still, so we'll go with that.
What are you expecting? Do you have any kind of predictions? Do you reckon it's going to stay wet? Do you reckon it might dry?
I mean, it's hard to say. It, you know, definitely looks a little bit lighter than it was earlier, but as we can see, it's still drizzling a little bit, and the track isn't actually that wet, so it'll be interesting, you know, if just that little bit of sun comes here, it will dry quite quickly.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you very much, Jack. Good luck.
Well, they are from the horse's mouth, wasn't it? That's exactly what the conditions are like. And as he was saying, that we saw Sete Gibino there. Look, at talking now to Danny Pedrosa, having a real long, hard look up at the sky, wasn't he, to see what it's doing. But the very situation of the circuit here is on a hillside. It's in the woods. The rain and the mist can hang in there a bit. It can clear. It's a very difficult prediction to make.
What a conundrum it is right now for all the teams and riders. As Cal Crutchlow, well, he made the best tyre choice last year, didn't he? He went with those hardest rain tyres and came through. At one stage in the first couple of laps, Cal Crutchlow was down in 15th place before he came through to a historic victory. Deep in discussion with his crew chief, Christophe Bourguignon there. It could all come down to tyre choice, flag-to-flag strategy. If it dries up quickly, when do you come in? It's going to be an intriguing 22-lap race.
This is where these men earn their money, isn't it? Without a shadow of a doubt. There's Maverick Viñales, but down in, well, on the grid, Dylan.
Yeah, guys, I'm down here with Alvaro Bautista now. Alvaro, we're just trying to understand from the riders, what's the track condition like? Is it okay for soft wets? Do you have to go with mediums?
Well, you never know, no? Because depends a lot the quantity of water in the track, no? Right now, it's more than this morning. This morning I used the soft in the rear, but it was too soft and I destroyed the tire in just a few laps. So now the option is to go on the medium in on the rear and see what happened. No, we have to try to understand all the condition of the track in every lap, because for sure will be different. So yeah, try to understand that and try to give the maximum. No, now we'll see what happened lap after lap.
Last year, many guys had problems with the front wet tyre, but I think this year they're quite a bit different. Are you worried about the front?
No, I'm more worried about the rear, no? That it was with the tyre I had the problem this morning. And for sure, the tyres are different from last year, so we will see. At the end, I think in the front there is no big difference between the medium and soft, so we'll see, you know, after the race. But my choice, I think I feel more confident for using the soft in the front and medium on the rear.
Hey, fantastic. Good luck. Thanks a lot, Alvaro.
Yeah, thanks, Alvaro Bautista. He has had a win here in the 125 class when he won that World Championship. Have a look there at the Johan Zarco. The clock is ticking down. It is 13:48. 12 minutes to go before the start of this round 10. The second half of the MotoGP season, and still tyre choice is the main focus in those riders' mind. We had a look then at Aleix Espargaró. 23 riders on the grid. Here is Alvaro Bautista. Both riders, we are, Jack Miller and Alvaro Bautista, have gone when asked about the weather, haven't they?
Yeah, I can't believe based on what they said. Sorry, Dylan.
And I don't blame them, because actually now on the grid, there's sun coming through, right? It's sun coming through. It feels warm. What we've heard apparently from the helicopter up in the sky, it does, however, look like rain, like more rain is coming. So I think that's the prediction that most of the teams have. And I think, you know, as we've heard, these guys will probably all have to go with the medium rear. Interesting to know that the fronts this year aren't so different, but you do imagine that at least what they decide on the grid here, okay, that they will have to stick with, but you do wonder then what's going to happen with the bikes in pit lane as well, if they're going to be changing them to dry very, very quickly or leaving a wet as a reserve.
11 minutes before the start of the race. Poi Lorenzo, well, he's put that Ducati with the new fairing on the second row of the grid. He is sixth fastest, has a good record here in all three classes, 125, 215, three times in those, and also a three times MotoGP winner, of course, then riding for Yamaha. Dylan.
Yeah, let me just butt in and chat with someone who last year did very well in these conditions, Loris Baz. Loris, you do have a serious look on your face, though, because I'm sure this must be one of those situations where you're just really not quite sure. I mean, are you going with the medium?
I don't know yet. It's what I'm thinking, you know. It depends if the track gonna dry or not. So, I don't know, it's 50-50. For sure we go with the wet in the front, and let's see with the rear, but I didn't have a good feeling this morning with this tire, that's the reason, and I had a really good feeling on Friday with the full wet, so we will see. The weather is pretty strange, so let's cross the finger and hope that what the decision we choose is the right one.
Sorry, just to understand, Loris, are you considering maybe going with the slick in the rear?
No, not yet. Maybe the full wet, but not the slick, not yet.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you very much. All right, thanks a lot, Loris.
Yeah, good for you, Dylan, because actually the way Loris said that, it did appear that he might be using a slick in the rear. That is not going to happen, is it?
Well, he just said as I walked away, now you've given me another idea.
You've completely clogged his mind, haven't you? Alex Rins, I had a look at him this morning, looking up at the weather. He was really disappointed. He qualified 13th place. Excellent qualifying from Alex Rins. Almost got into qualifying to just really completely starting his MotoGP career. Missed so much of the first half of the season with that broken wrist sustained at Austin in Texas. He's come back. He hasn't scored points in Assen or the Saxon Ring. But these are important races now for the former, you've got to say, Moto3 and Moto2 star.
Yeah, he's never gone three races in a row, Alex Rins, without scoring points in his Grand Prix career. So he'll be hoping to keep that proud record going today from a career-best MotoGP qualifying of 13th. Now, what's going into the rear of Marc Marquez's bike as a change here? Marc Marquez has decided, with about 8.5 minutes before we get underway here in Brno, to change that rain rear tyre. He's still locked in such detailed discussions with crew chief Santi Hernandez. Crucial decision to stake, certainly for the top riders. Marquez, Vinales, Dovizioso, Rossi and Pedrosa in the World Championship with 26 points splitting the top five. The rest, they can gamble, they can roll the dice a little bit, they've got nothing to lose, but those top five, these are critical decisions to be made.
Well, Jack Miller, as we said, he's the type of guy that can gamble. He gambled in Assen that year and he won the race just over a year ago. And they have got nothing to lose. The likes of Scott Redding, who's having such a bad time now, fighting for his very MotoGP future. He will take gambles here because suddenly, and he's done it on a couple of other occasions, he could find himself on the podium. And that's what you have to do when you're in their situation.
Definitely. Marc Marquez, if that is a face of concentration, I don't know what is. He is trying to make that final decision. He's already changed rear tyre once. Dylan, what's the information?
Well, guys, I've just been informed that he has changed to a soft option rear. Now, that to me says that they are expecting rain.
Now, that is also a gamble, because if it doesn't rain, we heard from Álvaro Bautista, who said he tried the soft rain tyre in the warm this morning and it destroyed itself after two laps. Jack Miller said he tried that soft rear tyre in the warm-up this morning. He said it was delaminating after six laps. So Marc Marquez will need to hope that the rain does indeed come.
Obviously declared a wet race as we stand at the moment. This is Hector Barbera. Very difficult first half of the season for the very experienced Grand Prix rider. but Hector Barbera, who's never been on the podium here, says he spent every day in the gym. We had a look at a bit of sunburn on his nose, didn't we? We thought he had sneaked out a couple of times during the break, but Hector Barbera's decent in these conditions. And Hector Barbera, again, is just one of those guys that is prepared to take the risk and go for it. As I would suspect, it's Carol Abraham in front of his home crowd.
Hector Barbera was fifth in the race here last year, and cash your minds back to that wet race in Malaysia. Last October, he was fourth, a career best for him. Great support here then, as you'd expect, in the Czech Republic. Those fans are gathered at turn number nine. In fact, those flags have been there since Wednesday, I believe. They got in obviously very, very early to show their vociferous local support for Carol Abraham.
Yeah, they rather like deck chairs on holiday, weren't they? They bagged their place about 3 days early, didn't they? Nobody had a chance to get to the best places. Valentino Rossi, he's making it very, very clear what he wants and what he's going to do. I think a clear mind's probably very important at this time. Dylan, have you got a clear mind?
Yeah, guys, I'm just looking at the tyres here. Bear with me very quickly, please. The only ones on the rear soft are Hector Barbera and Marc Márquez. The only ones on the front soft are Abraham, Bautista and Jack Miller. The rest, medium, medium.
Many thanks, Dylan. Right up to date. Well, the first half of the season was truly amazing. And we come into this race with just 10 points separating the first four riders. There's nine races to go. This surely is the best ever MotoGP World Championship in the 68-year history of the sport. What is going to happen this afternoon after what we've seen already this season? 2017 MotoGP.
Argentina.
The round two.
Marquez is crashed.
Vinales win.
Marquez.
Five out of five here in Texas.
Vinales moved through on Rossi and Dovizioso.
Oh, he's wide. Well, well, wide.
Marc Márquez for second place.
Rossi is through to take the lead. Now Rossi's down. Maverick Vinales takes over the lead here in Mugello. Dovizioso wins. Barcelona, we're underway.
Dovizioso in dreamland.
Two in a row.
Rossi's through on Márquez. Vinales has crashed. Márquez on the inside.
Valentino Rossi wins here in Aston.
We're in Germany.
Sachsenring.
Vinales has taken Rossi at the final corner.
The new leader. Márquez wins here in the Sachsenring. What a championship. 10 points separate. Four riders. What's next? Look up to the sky and ask the man up there, I think, because nobody really knows what's coming. Marc Márquez obviously has taken a little bit of a gamble. There you go. Confirmation, everybody on medium tyres. Apart from Márquez at wet weather tyres, it is a rear soft tyre, which suggests he and the team think it is going to rate. 22 laps, front row of the grid. Round 10 of the championship. Dani Pedrosa, Valentino Rossi, and the championship leader and the current world champion, Marc Márquez. Let battle commence once again. So welcome back to Bruno. I'm Nick Harris. Alongside me, Matt Burt. Down in pit lane, it's Dylan Gray. We're worried about the weather, but this is the lineup.
What a gamble by Marc Márquez. He's gone for that soft option rear tyre. Márquez, Rossi, Pedrosa on the front row. Dovizioso, Crutchlow and Jorge Lorenzo on the second row.
Third row of the grid. Vinales, Petrucci and Bautista. Fourth row, Zarco, Aleix Espargaró and Loris Baz.
Row five headed by Alex Rins. That's a career best MotoGP qualifying for him. Folger and Miller join him on that fifth row. Barbera, Abraham and Paul Espargaró on row six.
Row 7, Bradley Smith, Andrea Iannone and Tito Rabat. And row 8, Sam Lowes and Scott Redding. 23 riders, 22 laps of this magnificent Bruno circuit in the Czech Republic. And now the waiting is over. No changes now. You've made your decisions. And we have one final sighting lap. And racing will be underway after a 4-week summer break.
I think Mark Marquez has taken a real leap of faith here, Nick, going for that soft option rear tyre. Only him and Hector Barbera have decided to gamble for it. We heard from a couple of riders on the grid how quickly it deteriorated in the warm-up session this morning. This blue cloud, blue sky peeking through the cloud.
There's blue sky, but we also just had another little shower, and it's more about what they're thinking is going to be here in the next 5-10 minutes or so. And there are people saying that there is more rain to come, but as Jack Miller told us, as other guys have told us, they had quite some problems with that soft option rear. So I agree with you guys, I think it's a big gamble for Marc Marquez.
87,500 fans here today. Big crowd here yesterday, yet another one of the most popular sporting venues, certainly in the Czech Republic, certainly in Europe, one of the really big sporting events in Europe. You've got to say the conditions now, if we hadn't know what we know, you'd say, well, it looks all right out there now, doesn't it? It's quite bright, bit of blue sky around. It is a big, big gamble. Flares going off as they come into the stadium section. There we are, there are the former winners. Cal Crutchlow last year, Jorge Lorenzo the year before, and Danny Pedrosa 3 years ago. You remember, Marc Marquez was running away with the championship and had some problems here, and Danny Pedrosa went on to win the race. It's the first race in that year that Marc Marquez did not win.
Yeah, look at those yellow smoke bombs and flares going off. You're not in Mugello, you are actually still in Brno. Don't worry yet, race declared wet. Riders are allowed to swap bikes at any moment. Has Marc Marquez gone for that soft option Michelin rain rear tyre? You can see from the over.
It's a bit of a dry track.
But guys, bear in mind that a lot of these guys have their dry bikes with slicks started up in pit lane with a hot set of slicks should they wish to change.
You did say at one point some might have just a different setting of wet tyres on their set.
There is, yes. Yeah, the Aspar bikes, they've got the mediums on the rear. So some have a soft slick, medium slicks, others have the soft rear. Soft wet.
Sorry, based on what we saw in the warm-up, Nick, Marc Marquez needs water pretty quickly.
Yeah,
because
it's
drying up so quickly. Bautista and Miller, they couldn't get any longer than six laps out of that soft rear rain tyre. So Marquez, God, he really has rolled the dice, hasn't he?
Sorry to butt in very, very quickly. The other thing is, think of his lap he did this morning at the end. Very, very fast. He might be thinking, pull out a lead and then get onto the dry bike.
Yeah, a very good strategy indeed, Dylan. Right, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. We're in the Czech Republic. We are in Brno. The summer break is over. The Grand Prix of the Czech Republic. The boys are back in town.
Marc Marquez got a flyer from pole position. Valentino Rossi not quite away so well from the front row of the grid. Pedrosa already up in a second place. Lorenzo, though, picks him up. Lorenzo into second. Rossi already back in fifth. Vinales in sixth. Looks like Zarco's made a good start as well. Is that Folger? Jonas Folger has had a sensational start. He was 14th. Folger already up in the top six.
Well, I think Dylan's absolutely right. I think Marquez is going to try and scorch this for a few laps, don't you, with that softer option, a wet weather tyre. But Lorenzo quite comfortable in Dovizioso, so as you can see there, in third place. As they come into three and four before they plunge downhill towards turn five.
Well, initially with that soft option rear tyre, Marquez will have the better grip and it should get up to working temperature quicker. But Lorenzo straight away pounces up the inside of Marquez on the brakes at turn number five. Then Lorenzo leads the Czech Grand Prix on that radical newly fairing Ducati.
That's the last thing that Marc Marquez wanted. He wanted to get away, didn't he, and open up some big advantage and then hope the weather gods play their part. They're coming down into the stadium section for the very first time. They are there as the two Tech 3 bikes running together. But it's Jorge Lorenzo who leads the way into turn eight.
Lorenzo on the medium options. There is Marquez in second place. There's Dovizioso, Rossi, Danilo Petrucci's out well wide in turn number nine. That's going to cost him a few places. There's your 2016 Brno winner, Cal Crutchlow. Crutchlow's in seventh place at the moment. Vinales thought about a look up the inside of Pedrosa at the Kevin Schwantz corner, but no way through for Vinales.
They bottom out now, bottom end of the circuit, then they start the climb back up towards the start and finish. Left and right through turns 11 and 12, and then it's the long, long run up the hill towards 13 and 14. And still it's Lorenzo that leads the way, and that Ducati just gobbles up the tarmac as he races up towards turn 13.
Vinales got aggressive on Danny Pedrosa at turn number 11. He got himself up into sixth place. I think Pedrosa has been also overtaken by Johan Zarco. He has. So Dani Pedrosa just struggling on that first lap. He's been picked off by Vinales and Zarco in very quick succession. That one completed. The race leader, Jorge Lorenzo. He's already established a lead of almost 7.5 tenths over Marquez. And it's Dovizioso and Rossi now piling the pressure on Marc Marquez. How much longer will Marquez's soft option rear rain tyre last? We know it deteriorated very, very quickly for a couple of rides in that warm-up session. He's under real pressure from Dovizioso and Rossi now.
Here they come down towards turn three. They're going to try and outbreak him into turn three. Rossi thinks about getting up the inside of Dovizioso, but then just bides his time.
Trucci thought about looking up the inside of Cal Crutchlow, thought better of it down at turn number three. Squeeze the brake in any harder, he might have tucked the front there. Petrucci, Lorenzo's got a really big lead now, it's over 1 second, and Rossi's up the inside of Dovizioso, and Rossi's up the inside of Marc Marquez. Valentino Rossi in one move picks up two places. Rossi into second place.
This stadium section is going to go completely crazy. This is where all the Rossi fans are.
Marquez is really suffering. Dovizioso's got him now. He's up the inside again there, Andrea Dovizioso. Dovizioso running a little bit wide at turn number seven. Marquez was able to fight back through. Dovizioso strikes back again, though, as they come through turn number eight. Has Marc Marquez's gamble backfired already?
It certainly appears at this very moment it is, because Vinales is all over him swallowed like a rat. He's been absolutely swallowed up by the field. He must be, and his team must be praying for rain. Dylan, just a very quick word on the weather. Any sign of any rain?
No sign of any rain. So, and bear in mind, Marquez's number two bike is set up completely for the dry. That's got slicks on it.
Well, he's dropping like a stone here. It's embarrassing. He's being picked off with ease. Marc Marquez does not drop back through a field like this unless he's got some confidence. Look at this. He's got no grip whatsoever. Petrucci and Crutchlow pick him off like he's a novice.
Well, think of what Jack Miller told us on the grid. He said he made that soft only last for only one lap in the warm-up this morning.
Is it a major mistake by Marquez and Honda? We may be proved wrong. We're still 20 and a half laps to go. Jorge Lorenzo is absolutely on fire at the front.
Marquez is coming in. We've got loads of riders coming in now.
Oh, what a sensational start to the race here in Bruno. Marquez in, and this is with slick tyres, you say, Dylan?
This is slick tyres. We have Jack Miller onto slicks as well. We have both the KTMs and Jonas Folger as well. Oh.
Wow, so Folger's in, Marquez are heading out on full slick tyres. Drama here indeed in Bruno. So Marquez, on the end of lap two, decided to come in. He was dropping back through the field like a stone. How much longer are these rain tyres, even the harder options, the medium tyres, going to last on this rapidly drying surface? They all start to overheat very, very quickly. The riders will start to feel like they're riding on jelly and marbles very, very quickly.
We ride with Dovizioso, that is Johan Zarco behind him. But now they have to be considering, I think Marquez had no choice, but the guys on the medium tyres must be starting to think, you know, we're going to have to come in.
Well, Marquez initially wants it to rain. Now the last thing he needs is
rain. Yeah. Has he pulled a mighty big, clever conjuring trick by almost fooling everybody and then getting back out there on the slick tyres? I don't think really anybody knows what the weather is going to do.
Well, normally in flag-to-flag scenarios, Marc Marquez and his Repsol Honda team get it absolutely bang on the money. The pit lane's going to get very, very busy very, very shortly, I feel.
And guys, not everyone is ready. Dobby's bike, his second bike, is now having to be changed to a dry setup, as is Jorge Lorenzo's, because they were ready with another wet bike now. And of course, it's not just the tyres, it's the link, got to change the suspension, many things.
Yeah, you can see these guys have got no grip. Carol Abraham is being told to come in. There you can see team communication. He's getting that message on his dashboard now. Tyre change, come into the pits. Do not stay out any longer. The track's too dry for wet tyres. It's going to be really fascinating to see the pace of Marc Marquez on full slicks compared to these riders, the likes of Lorenzo, Rossi, Zarco, Dovizioso and Vinales, who are out there on the rain tyres. Rossi's just set the fastest lap of the race, a 208.3. Alex Rins has just bettered that with a 207.6. Scott Redding and Lacy Spargo have also decided to come in. They've seen enough on those medium rain tyres.
Here is Marc Marquez. He is on slicks, loads into the pits now. We wait for Marquez to come.
Oh, there's been a fall in the pit lane. Somebody's gone down the pit lane. Was that Andrea Iannone? Andrea Iannone, I think, yeah, he's crashed in the pit lane.
can any more happen in this race? Espargaró back in the race, Redding back in the race, everybody coming in. Marquez at the moment in 19th place. Do you know he's only 8 seconds down now on Jorge Lorenzo?
Folger is in. They're all bunching up. These guys have got to come in. There's no way that these rain tyres, there's still 19 laps to go. They're already starting to feel like slicks. They've got no tread on them hardly whatsoever. They're going to really, really struggle, these riders. Box change communication coming in for Loris Bass. Surely they're going to have to come in.
What's the situation at Ducati, Dylan? I mean, have they got Dovizioso's bike ready yet?
Yes, they not quite. If he came in now, he would not have a bike at the moment. Same goes for Jorge Lorenzo. Not ready yet. The Yamahas, they are good to go.
Well, that's obviously why they haven't boarded or communicated with Lorenzo. And if it chose to come in, Lorenzo has a good long look over his left shoulder. He knows he just hasn't got any pace, any feeling at all on those medium rain tyres. Rossi leads. It was given to him by Jorge Lorenzo in many respects. But Rossi then leads this Grand Prix. Well, there's no way, unless the heavens open right now, that these guys are going to be able to finish this Grand Prix on the tyres that they are currently running now. The track is far too dry for Michelin rain tyres.
So Rossi leads the way. There is Lorenzo. Behind Lorenzo, Zarco and Dovizioso. Maverick Viñales is also in there. But it's really who is going to come in and who is ready to come in. Box
Lorenzo still not ready. Ducati still not ready.
Rossi's going round again. Lorenzo's coming in, Dylan, even though he doesn't know his bike's not ready. Lorenzo's come in. Petrucci was getting a message coming. Viñales has come in. Petrucci has come in. Rossi's gone round again, as has Johann Zarco, as has Andrea Dovizioso.
Right, are they ready for Jorge Lorenzo? We are about to find out.
Well, they are not completely ready. Not completely ready.
Pedrosa came in as well. Marc Marquez has just gone through. He's lapping 10 seconds faster than Valentino Rossi. Marc Marquez, you know, might have absolutely pulled off a stroke of genius here right now.
Right, pack back in. Things will settle down just a little bit, not for a little while. So Rossi still leads the way, but Marquez, who came in so early to change the slick tyres, is putting in laps that nobody else can match.
So only Rossi, Zarco and Dovizioso, your trio on screen right now. These are the only three guys that have not come in. These three are on the medium Michelin rain tyres. Now, we've seen it before that Rossi and Dovizioso stay out too long in these kind of
Sachsenring. Not this year, Dylan.
Well, I do believe Dovi would have been told that don't come in until we tell you to, because your bike is in wet setting. If you saw, you maybe didn't see it, Lorenzo, he got on his second bike and they had to get the starter out and start it up. He lost a lot of time in the pits here. Rossi's team, however, they are still ready. So is Zarco.
Zarco called it wrong, didn't he, in Assen. He came in too early and I think he's just basing his judgment now on what Valentino Rossi's doing.
Surely Rossi's got to come in. Surely Rossi's got to come in, followed by the two behind him. Here they are. There is Zarco. There is Dovizioso. 46 box.
Hector Barber's just come in as well. Rossi has to come in, surely, this time around. He cannot continue.
Well, he's starting up horsepower hill any moment now. Here is Marquez. He could have pulled the master stroke.
Marquez has already been in the pits and he's in the same shot as the top three. Rossi, is he coming in this time around? He is. So Rossi's in. Marquez will be coming through very shortly. Zarco stayed out. Zarco has seriously rolled the dice. But Marquez then is coming through the final corner now. He's over the line now, Marc Marquez. He's in second place. He's 9 seconds faster than Johann Zarco. And Valentino Rossi's coming the pits. It's a lap or two late for Rossi.
Rossi in. Flag to flag for Rossi. Back out, number 46. Where will he be when he comes? Well, obviously on the next lap. Rossi out, as you can see, Dovizioso out. Pit lane speed limit. Can't pick up the pace until they come over the line. There, here we go.
Marc Marquez and somebody at HRC is about to, unless it dramatically changes, be credited with a genius decision. He's leading the race.
Marquez leading the way, and he is just going to disappear from Johann Zarco, because Zarco is still on those wet weather tyres. Marquez came in, was it at the end of the first lap or the second lap? Second lap, wasn't it? Came in, changed.
Look at the difference.
It almost appeared that it was deliberate, doesn't it?
The difference is unbelievable. I mean, it looks like Johann Zarco is riding a Moto3 bike out there at the moment. Just look at the difference between full slicks and full wet tyres on a drying surface here in Brno. Chalk and cheese between Marquez and Johan Zarco.
What happens if it starts raining now? What? I dare not think. Long, long way to go. 16 and a half laps to go, but Marquez, masterstroke as we stand at the moment. But at the let's be honest, at the start, we put our hands up and say we think they've made a massive mistake. And I think we started to think perhaps they pulled an absolute masterstroke here. They have as we stand at the moment.
Something happened in the pit lane then between Iannone and Aleix Espargaró. We clearly saw Andrea Iannone was on the floor. It's currently under investigation. Didn't really see what kick-started that incident, but there was no doubt about it. Andrea Iannone definitely crashed the pit lane. Fingers crossed that there was no injuries to any team personnel in that incident. As we look at Scott Redding and Aleix Espargaró, Marquez has just come over the line to start lap number 7. He's doing 157s, Marquez. Now, Scott Redding's going to come over the line in second place. Zarco's come into pit lane. So here is Redding on the road then in second place. Zarco's left it far, far too late.
There's that little twirl. There's a spin in the middle. But Redding will be into second place. Aleix Espargaró, Karel Edman, Pedrosa, Petrucci, Rins, Crutchlow 9, Miller, Vinales, Baz, Paul Espargaró, Rossi, Dovizioso, Rabat, Smith, Sam Lowes, Jorge Lorenzo in 19th place, Bautista in 20th. And no sign of Iannone at the moment, so I don't know if his race actually ended in pit lane, but as we look at the moment, he does appear, well, Jonas Folger in 21st place. Let's see if we find Andrea Iannone and Hector Barbera out of the race as well.
Aleix Espargaró then is up into second place.
Guys, just a quick word, all Suzuki mechanics and personnel were okay after the incident, but they also still don't know how it happened because they weren't exactly paying attention.
Sorry, Hector Barbera is now, they're both across the line. Iannone in 22nd place, Hector Barbera in 23.
Quick word on Hector Barbera. He had gone out on slicks but came back in and seemed to have some problem with the rear of the bike, but his team sent him back out again.
Right, we're going to take one more lap because I think Zarco's going to go way down, isn't it? When we have a look at the when they go over the line standings for the next time, and then that will be where we're at, really, won't it?
Yeah, it's Marquez, Aleix Espargaró, Redding, and Karel Abraham in fourth place. Pedrosa fifth, then Petrucci, Crutchlow, Rins, Miller, and Vinales are your top 10. This at the moment is the battle for second, which is being won quite convincingly at the moment by Aleix Espargaró. That there's obviously been some kind of incident in the pit lane involving the Spanish rider and Andrea Iannone, which is currently under investigation. Here's Marc Marquez in a race all on his lonesome at the front of the field here in Brno. He's over the line, still lapping in those mid 157s.
15 minutes ago, Matt and myself were open mouthed at the decision by Honda to go out on that softer option wet weather tyre. Honda knows something we did. He went out for two laps, came in, changed the slicks. He's crossed the line now with 15 laps to go with a 19-second advantage. Was it luck or was it brilliant?
Was it all part of a cunning plan, shall we say? Yeah, it might have been his strategy. Karel Abraham, he could be on course here for a sensational podium finish here in the Czech Republic. Now, I hope they're not too fresh spots away on our camera lens down at turn number 3. Here's Valentino Rossi.
Trying to get behind, trying to get past Paul Espargaró. This is a battle for 12th place. Don't forget, Valentino Rossi, what, three laps ago, actually led the way before he came in and had to change to the slick tyres.
Well, this could be a massive pendulum swing towards Marc Marquez in terms of the World Championship. He leads by almost 20 seconds, and his closest rivals, Vinales 9th, Rossi 13th, Dovizioso 14th. We may well look back at Valencia and how pivotal this Brno race was, certainly if it stays as is, with Marc Marquez presently cruising to a second successive win. He won in Germany, of course, 23 points. He would head to the Red Bull Ring in Austria if you threw the chequered flag right now. But the way today's gone, who knows, there might be another couple of surprises still to come.
Yeah, that could come with spots of rain. Rossi and Dovizioso are behind Paul Espargaró. This is the battle for 12th place as they come down towards the Kevin Schwantz corner. That would be the championship position. 23-point advantage Marquez has been had. So he would have opened up another 18 points.
Good enough track excursion to Polispargaro. So Marquez comfortably on his own at the front of this race, still setting the fastest lap, 157.4 last time around for Marquez. It's still Aleix Espargaró, 4/10 clear of Scott Brennan, who's in turn just about holding off the advances of Carol Abraham. That's Pedrosa, Petrucci, Croxlow, Vincent, Vinales, Miller, your top 10.
Yeah, it's pretty tight after Marquez. And with the changing conditions, everything else, it's going to be interesting. But front, and he can ride a race at the front, Mark Marquez. Seen it on a many occasion. Did he take the gamble, or did they really know it wasn't going to rain? Were they prepared to take the risk? Well, they certainly were. This is a great ride by Aleix Espargaró. But as Matt said, there has been an incident in pit lane involving him and Andre Iannone, and Race Direction are looking at that incident. Let's keep our fingers crossed for both, but especially for Aleix Espargaró. Could put that Aprilia on the podium, that there are no penalties involved in. What a day for Scott Redding. Don't rule out Danny Pedrosa now. He can very easily see the chance of a Honda 1-2 in this race.
Yeah, Danny Pedrosa ruthlessly up the inside of Carol Abraham. So Pedrosa has now taken fourth place, and the podium well within sight of Danny Pedrosa, who will be clawing back right to championship points on the likes of Vinales, Dovizioso and Rossi. We know that Scott Redding in the dry has really struggled for pace, and he's wide at turn five. Danny Pedrosa didn't even have to fight for that one. Sorry, turn 10 rather, down the Kevin Schwantz corner. And Pedrosa's the man really charging through the pack here, scything his way through the field. He's next got Aleix Espargaró in his sights. We could very shortly have a Repsol Honda 1-2 here, Bruno. Big moment for Aleix Espargaró as he got on the gas coming up Horsepower Hill.
Yeah, any moment now, Danny Pedrosa is on the charts. This is Pedrosa at his best. Remember how he carved through the field? Was it Misano last year? This is very reminiscent, but he's got a 20-second advantage, his teammate, and even Danny Pedrosa in this sort of form, I don't think he's going to be able to pull that back. Pedrosa crosses the line, though, in second place. 22.7 seconds down on his teammate, Marc Márquez.
Yeah, Pedrosa, he made a couple of moves on that lap look really easy. Dovizioso and Rossi then have found their way through on Polispargaró. So Rossi 12th, Dovizioso now up in a 13th. Rossi next in his eye line is Loris Baz in 11th position. It's on board with Maverick Vinales, who's currently running in 8th place. He's trying to hunt down Cal Crutchlow.
Absolute disaster for Rossi and Dovizioso, isn't it? Who are in that riders within 10 points of, Rossi 10 points behind Marquez, and of course Dovizioso just 6. This is an absolute disaster. But
like Dylan said, Dovizioso's hand was forced a little bit because they couldn't bring him in, the bike wasn't ready, so he had to stay out a little bit longer than what he would have hoped for.
How does the sky look, Dylan? I'm sorry I have to keep asking you, but you know, it could be another twist in the tail, yeah.
Well, it's a little bit blue, it's a little bit cloudy. It's one of those where we haven't had any spit since they've changed bikes, so that's good news in a way, but we have seen it change so quickly, so many times, and that was just today.
Yeah, poor old Scott Redding's really coming under pressure now. Carol Abraham is in front of him, and it's Cal Crutchlow also putting pressure.
Oh, big contact. Petrucci got in a bit hot down at the Kevin Schwantz corner, gave Carol Abraham a real big nudge. Abraham has to force it out wide, and he loses the place also to Cal Crutchlow. So pretty hard move there by Petrucci down at turn number 10.
He eased him out speedway style, didn't he? Just open the door up. There is Crutchlow, there is Petrucci.
You look at the lap times on slick tyres as well. Marquez is so much faster than anybody else. He's in the 157s. The only riders last time around were in the 157s were Pedrosa, Rossi and Dovizioso. Pedrosa's actually just put in the fastest lap of the race, a 157.3. The problem is he's 22.5 seconds behind your race leader, Marc Márquez, as we track Rossi over the line in 11th.
Right, let's try and settle things down a bit. Marquez, Pedrosa, Aleix Espargaró third, four Redding, five, no, sorry, Petrucci. No, sorry, get it right. Four Redding, five Petrucci, six Crutchlow, seven Abraham, eight Vinales, nine Rins, 10 Miller, 11 Rossi, 12 Dovizioso, 13 Paul Espargaró, 14 Loris Baz, 15th Johan Zarco, the Tito Rabat, Bradley Smith, Sam Lowes, Jorge Lorenzo, Jonas Folger, and Alvaro Bautista, Iannone and Barbara yet to cross the line.
Briefly on board there with the fastest man on track right now, Danny Pedrosa. was pretty comfortably streaking away from the chasing pack. Petrucci up the inside of his Pramac Nakheli teammate, Scott Redding at turn five. Redding really struggling to hang in this podium battle. We know he had issues on slick tyres. He qualified in last place yesterday. He thought the rain might be his saviour, but as the track's dried up, he's really dropping back through the field now.
There is Alexis Parker. This is now the battle for third place. There's Petrucci. Here we go. There is a Spargo Petrucci. Redding, Crutchlow, Carol Abraham. Well, he finished seventh in Assen, didn't he, Carol Abraham? So this would equally be the best result of the season so far.
Well, Alexis Spargo presently on course to give them probably their first ever podium in the MotoGP World Championship. They've only had a best of six since they returned, and when they were previously here in the early four-stroke here with the likes of Colin Edwards and Noriyuki Haga and Regis Laconi.
Well, we ride with Maverick Vinales. That is Carol Abraham in front of him. Some very, very important points now. I won't say up for grabs for Maverick Vinales, but he has an opportunity to grab some points and open up a little bit of a gap on Dovizioso and Rossi in the championship battle. He ain't going to close the gap, though, on the man at the front, Marc Márquez.
No. Pedrosa's got serious pace, as has Andrea Dovizioso. Dovizioso's just fired in the fastest lap of the race. You can see on the screens there, a 1:57.183. And he's in 12th place, hunting down Jack Miller very, very quickly. Petrucci then moves up into third place, up the inside of Aleix Espargaró. No problems, no dramas at turn three, but Espargaró fights straight back at turn number four. Aleix Espargaró then back into third place. Cal Crutchlow as well, sniffing around the podium again here in Brno.
You wouldn't want to mess with Petrucci or Aleix Espargaró in battles like this, I can absolutely promise you. Well, imagine we're riding with Cal Crutchlow, aren't we, here, just watching what's going on in front of him, certainly where. There is Petrucci, 9. 41 is Aleix Espargaró. They come down into the stadium section. That means there is 10 and a half laps to go of this round 10 of the championship. Full marks to Aleix Espargaró. He is desperate, isn't he, to give Aprilia that first podium finish. They're through turn 9. They come a little bit up, then they plunge down now to the Kevin Schwantz corner, turn 10. And we ride with Cal Crutchlow, last year's winner.
Yeah, Petrucci might be able to blast up Horsepower Hill against the Aprilia, and the Ducati against the Aprilia in a horsepower race is a no contest. They have got an upgraded engine here this weekend, Dab Aprilia, but it's still not a match for the superior power of the Ducati. On board with Cal Crutchlow as we come through turn number 12, out of Horsepower Hill. Vinales is there now, putting real pressure on Scott Redding. As Petrucci found his way through, he has, using the grunt of that Ducati GP 17. So Petrucci snatches back third from Aleix Espargaró.
Yeah, and this time he's made it stick. If you remember, Aleix Espargaró got him back coming through turn 14. Not this time around. Cal Crutchlow is in there. Will he have a look at the pair of them, or perhaps one of them coming into this long right-hander turn one? Saw Vinales there running in sixth place, running in seventh now. Abraham in eighth. Ninth is Rins, and Valentino Rossi 10. Vizioso 11.
Fastest lap of the race has now gone to Jonas Folger. He's in 17th place and 1:57.139. On board again with Cal Crutchlow through turn three. Maverick Vinales is coming back into podium contention here as well. Vinales under a second behind Cal Crutchlow, so Vinales might be salvaging a podium here. Pretty tight there, didn't it, between Crutchlow and Aleix Espargaró at turn 13.
This is the battle between Redding and Vinales, and Vinales
round the outside
at turn 14.
He's got into his rhythm here, hasn't he? Very nicely.
Yeah, he
Vinales. He looks well sharp now. He looks the strongest actually of this quartet circulating. Redding's now coming under pressure from Abraham.
Yeah, Petrucci, Aleix Espargaró, Crutchlow are going to get Vinales, really giving them a tough old go at the moment. So 20 points as it stands at the moment would be the difference in the World Championship. And if Vinales can get past the three in front of him, sounds easy, doesn't it? Not as easy, but he does look in good nick behind Cal Crutchlow as we ride with him. He could certainly, well, obviously, close the gap on Márquez at the front. Márquez with a 21-second lead.
Well, he had a place given to him there by Aleix Espargaró. Aleix Espargaró got a good long look over his shoulder coming out of turn number 10. And he got mugged by Maverick Vinales. So more points up for grabs. There you can see the live championship. Another point in the pocket for Vinales. He will fancy chance of getting on the podium now, Maverick Vinales, on board with the runaway race leader, Marc Márquez.
Oh, Carol Abraham crashes out of his home Grand Prix. What a shame.
It's Bautista, I think, isn't it?
Oh, I'm so sorry. It is Alvaro Bautista. We're going to look at it now.
Yeah.
Yeah, front end.
Turn number 10, fast old crash, just lost.
That's where he crashed on Saturday morning.
Yeah, that oil leak, didn't he, in FP3 yesterday. So Bautista, it's over for him.
Right, this is Maverick Vinales. Some crucial points up for grabs for him, but he's got some good men in front of him. The first man in front of him is the man that won the race here last year.
Well, Ross is coming into this as well. Valentino Rossi has got onto the back of Carol Abraham and Scott Brennan, who he's much faster than. Waste no time in dispensing of Carol Abraham at turn number four. And Rossi is only about, well, he's less than 2 seconds behind Vinales now. So Valentino Rossi still might be able to salvage a surprise podium here in Brno.
8.5 laps ago, this is the battle for third place. The two Repsol Hondas out the front have disappeared. I was going to say to the sunshine, but it's not quite sunshine. We will tell you the full story in a minute. It has been the most amazing start to this race. Yeah, this is really hotting up. We ride with Rossi. That's Scott Redding in front of him. I don't think poor old Scott Redding's going to be in front for too much longer. Through turn nine, down towards the Swans corner now. Here comes Rossi on the brakes up the inside at turn 10. I don't think there's any way for Scott Redding to go. There's not. And Rossi up another place. Rossi now up into seventh place.
Yeah, Redding's really struggling. Looks like he's struggling for front grip, rear grip. The Vizioso is about to pick up Carol Abraham as well. So Carol Abraham, who at one stage a few laps ago looked like he was competing for what would have been a dream, a sensational home podium here in Brno, now he's going to be fighting just to hang on inside the top 10. Alexis Spargo's podium challenge looks like it's run its course. He's really struggling to go with Petrucci, Crutchlow and Vinales.
This is a crucial one. It's going to be seven laps, isn't it, as far as the, sorry, eight laps as far as the championship goes. Because there's some very, very important points for the likes of Rossi, Vinales and Dovizioso to pick up in these final eight. Because 25, you imagine, are going to Marc Márquez. He's going to increase his lead in the championship. But now this trio of riders have got to pick up as many points as they possibly can. And Dovizioso is past Abraham.
And Alessio Spargo's got to drop back three places. He'll be getting that message now on his dashboard, Alexis Spargo. That's obviously why he was looking over his shoulder when he saw Vinales, maybe. We said that he never, Vinales.
And is that the incident in pit lane?
An unsafe release in pit lane, basically. So that was the reason why he was obviously being released by Aprilia when Andrea Ghidoni was coming in. Now, as the team that's releasing you, right, you've got to make sure you can do it safely. The race director have obviously viewed the footage and realised that it wasn't safe. So Alexis Spargo is having to yield three places, which is going to give crucial points to, well, Rossi, certainly, and probably Dovizioso. As Vinales has picked off Crutchlow.
Picked up Crutchlow, he's now running in third, fourth place. If you pick up a third place, that will be a bit morale booster to Maverick Vinales. There's nothing he can do for what happened at the front with Marc Márquez at the training time. There you go. Exactly what Matt has been telling you. Alessio Spargo to drop three positions due to unsafe release in the pit lane. There was an incident involving Andrea Iannone, and here comes Vinales up the inside of Danilo Petrucci. This is as hard as I've seen Maverick Vinales ride since he probably finished second in Mugello.
Yeah, and there's Valentino Rossi just coming into your picture briefly out of turn number 12. You can see the podium now, Rossi. Has he got enough time? And now Vinales has been able to find a way through, and Crutchlow and Petrucci, has he got the pace to be able to make a break and deny Rossi the chance to fight back? This is the incident then. Here comes Andrea Iannone in. It was close between Iannone. Yeah, what happened was there, Alessio Spargo and his team, well, his team really should have held Alessio Spargo until Andrea Iannone had safely pulled in. Andrea Iannone basically toppled off because he thought he was going to slam into the side of Alessio Spargo, and that's the reason why Alessio Spargo was found to be the guilty party there.
Well, if you just tuned in and you think, what the hell has happened here? 20 second advantage for Marc Márquez at the front. He chose to go out on the damp track on a soft option rear wet weather tyre. We were astounded. He was dropping down the field like a fly. But did they know something about the weather that we did not? Because after two laps, he came in and he changed to a bike with slick tyres, and the rest is history.
Well, history has also shown us, Nick, that in flag-to-flag scenarios, HRC and Marc Marquez tend to get their strategy absolutely bang on the money, whereas Yamaha and Valentino Rossi, they are sometimes a little bit behind the eight ball.
Was a difficult situation because of the weather conditions. Some teams at the start of the race had bikes ready with a different set of wet weather tyres. Honda knew exactly what they were doing. They were ready for Marquez to come in and change to slicks. We thought it might be a gamble at the time. Certainly no gamble, but here is Vinales now comfortably in third place.
Yeah, he's clearing off, isn't he? He's leaving Petrucci and Crutchlow behind him. Cal Crutchlow has moved up into fourth place now. This is good for Maverick Vinales, a championship challenge, because it's only 14 points then behind Marc Marquez, so he's only going to be surrendering 9 points. It could have been a lot worse. Lois Baz has crashed out. We thought it was going to be a wet race. Lois Baz might be a contender for the podium, but unfortunately he's crashed out of 14th place.
Here is Cal Crutchlow, of course, the one that raced here last year. Having a good old fight over with Danilo Petrucci, but he leads the way. But you just saw over the right shoulder there of Danilo Petrucci, Rossi is coming.
Yeah, he's definitely got pace here, Rossi. If he can chase down Petrucci and Crutchlow, then that's definitely vital championship points for Valentino Rossi. If he can take a fourth place, he'll be happy with that, that's for sure. It looks like he's got... Yeah, he was in the 157s. There's Lois Baz crashing out. That's at turn seven. Rossi last time around was a second faster than Petrucci. So he should be able to catch them and pass them pretty easily with the pace that Rossi showed last time around.
This is Crutchlow and Petrucci. Rossi, as you can see, closing all the time. And as I said earlier, it's absolutely vital world championship points for Rossi and Dovizioso, because Rossi in sixth place, Dovizioso currently in seventh. Marquez just clearing off at the front. Oh, he's slipping. He's slipped aboard under 20 second advantage. Only 19.961 then. But it doesn't appear with 5.5 laps to go that the weather's going to change. I'm dying to hear what he says to Dylan in pit lane if he wins the race. Was it a gamble or was it absolutely deliberately done? I have a feeling they did it deliberately. They really thought the weather was going to do exactly what it has done. Here is Rossi. We ride with him right behind Danilo Petrucci, his great mate.
Yeah, Petrucci struggling for grip here. You can see Cal Crutchlow streaking away from the Italian. Rossi will find it difficult to stay on the back wheel of Petrucci coming out of Horsepower Hill, because the Ducati, we know, has got the far, far superior grunt and acceleration, although Petrucci perhaps suffering a bit with a lack of rear grip. Yeah, he is. You can see Rossi got that Yamaha hooked up a little bit better. He's not close enough to attack at turn number 13, though, on Petrucci. Petrucci out a little bit wide. Looks like he's losing front and rear grip right now. That like Petrucci. Yeah, Rossi's going to pounce the first corner, surely.
Here they come over the line almost side by side. Rossi eyes him up. There's plenty of lines at this very long, wide first corner. No. Rossi not able to get through. You'd think when they get down to 3 and 4, the first of the fast S section, that Rossi would try and nip up the inside or try and get round the outside as they come out at turn 4. Here's Cal Crutchlow, still running in fourth place.
Ducati power proving crucial for Petrucci. Rossi this time though up the inside at turn 3. Nicely done by Rossi then. So he's up now into fifth place. The gap to Cal Crutchlow is a couple of tenths. So Rossi, just over 4 laps to go, has got time to hunt down Cal Crutchlow. I don't think Crutchlow or Rossi are going to be putting any pressure on Maverick Vinales for third place. Vinales looks pretty comfortable. He's 1.5 seconds clear of Cal Crutchlow.
Championship-wise now, can Dovizioso get past Petrucci, pick up some more world championship points with 4.5 laps to go? Well, here is Crutchlow, just got a glimpse of Rossi and Petrucci behind him.
Yeah, second then, the gap between Crutchlow and Rossi. So it's doable for Valentino Rossi, but hunting down Cal Crutchlow on a Renault circuit that he won on last year is not an easy task.
And getting past him, no. He's got a good ride, Cal Crutchlow. Still suffering with that back injury sustained in the crash on Saturday morning. Crash that also saw Marc Marquez and Alvaro Bautista go down. I'm still gobsmacked, is the word, I think, at what Marquez and his team have done. And if it was deliberate, it's one of the masterstrokes of all masterstrokes, isn't it?
You wonder how close he was to maybe even starting on slick tyres.
Perhaps he just didn't want to give the game away. You know, perhaps he didn't want to do it. just thought, no, I'm just going to, I'll do two laps, come in, this is going to be okay.
Well, he only did two laps on the rain tyres, then he came in, so you could have done the whole race actually on slick tyres.
Oh, without a shadow of a doubt he could, but nobody quite knew. When they went round on that final cycling lap, I remember you saying, you know, there's some real dry lines and patches appearing.
So four laps to go. Rossi has taken a couple of tenths out of Crutchlow last time around. It's 8 tenths then, the gap between Crutchlow, just going through turn three now, and Valentino Rossi. Rossi's come from 14th then to fourth place. It looks like Danilo Petrucci's got nothing left in the tank. He's going to now be aiming to keep himself in that top six ahead of Andrea Dovizioso.
We arrive with Marc Márquez. I really don't know how you can describe this performance. What's he got on the slick tyres? Absolutely faultless. Masterstroke of planning. We will ask, I absolutely assure you, was it absolutely intended to do that? To fool the opposition a little bit, knowing the track was going to dry. We thought that Honda had a weather forecast that said it was definitely going to rain. They might have had exactly the opposite. Still a gamble to take though, wasn't it, to do what they did? So those gambles, if they work, you're regarded as a genius. If they don't, you're regarded, well, people just say, what the hell were they playing at?
Yeah, I mean, the more you think about it, the more you think it actually was that they totally intended it. It was all so part of their game plan. It was all part of the strategy.
Yeah.
They are so clever in this situation. When we've had flag-to-flag race in the past, if my memory serves me right, Marc Márquez is on a real dominant sequence of race wins in flag-to-flag races. He just calls it so brilliantly with his team.
This is a Maverick Vinales. Tell you what, this is as good as I've seen Maverick Vinales ride for a bit. This third place, I think just the third place, but the way he's ridden, he's going to do his confidence a great deal of good, and he hasn't let Márquez get away with the championship back. There you are, fourth place for Cal Crutchlow. So we look at Maverick Vinales running in third. It's rather lonely for him. Pedrosa in second place. Forgotten all about Danny Pedrosa, who's also ridden a really good race. But there is Crutchlow, there is Rossi.
Yeah, Rossi just can't.
No, he can't really close the gap
enough. He's just in a bit of a brick wall now, Rossi. Crutchlow's keeping that gap around 8 tenths of a second.
I'd rather like it in the Petrucci Dovizioso battle. He is closing, but I don't think he's closing enough to actually get past him.
Yeah, Cal Crutchlow, he won't. You would feel, barring a mistake from Maverick Vinales, be back on the podium here in Brno. Lucio Cecchinello looking pretty pensive. The gap between Vinales and Crutchlow is 1.7 seconds. Vinales is not going to be throwing away that gap unless he makes an almighty mistake. Lynn Jarvis looking on. Well, they've been outfoxed again by Honda and Marquez, haven't they?
They've been out-thought, out-gambled. I don't know what there's many, many words you could use. It is an amazing season, on and off the track, isn't it? People making decisions that you just think, what the hell is going on here? And as it turned out, well, there is Crutchlow, there is Rossi.
He's found a couple of tenths then, Rossi, in the first couple of sectors on this lap. Live championship, 14 points, the gap between Márquez and Vinales going to the Red Bull Ring in Austria next weekend, where you've got to say Ducati will be a big favourite based on what we saw last year when Iannone and Dovizioso dominated at the Red Bull Ring.
We ride with Rossi. The man in the distance is Crutchlow. They're coming down towards the Kevin Schwantz corner. This is a Petrucci and Dovizioso. Yeah, I think Vinales, I think after everything that's happened, you'd say 14 points. Okay, he's increased the lead by 9, but with everything that had happened, it could have been an absolute disaster. Two laps to go, it's across the line.
So Rossi hit the brick wall, he's just smashed his way through it. He's just put in his personal best lap of the race, a 1:57.092. On that last lap around, he was 4 tenths of a second faster than Crutchlow.
Two to go, it could be a mighty tight last lap. There is Crutchlow, 35-46, of course, Valentino Rossi. A very important battle for fourth place because there's some crucial World Championship points
at stake.
And Rossi really has got him in his sights now as it comes through turn four, down towards five. Is he close enough? Have a go here. We ride with Valentino Rossi on the brakes. He thinks about it and then thinks, no, I'm going to wait.
Crutchlow's out wide though and Rossi sweeps through. Cal Crutchlow got in a little bit hot. No, Rossi wasn't able to sweep through, but Crutchlow was definitely out a little bit wide at turn number five.
Struggling a bit here, Cal Crutchlow. Rossi right behind him. Stadium section along the plateau here, then into 8 and 9. It's the left and right. Rossi can get out here tight. He might have a go as they go down towards turn 10, the Kevin Schwartz corner. We switch back now to Crutchlow. A lap and a half to go. This is the battle for fourth. Here comes Rossi. No, not close enough again.
Crutchlow. Oh, Dovizioso's got Petrucci. Dovizioso picks up another very precious World Championship point then. He's up in a seventh place. Of course, Rossi, if he can get through on Crutchlow, he picks up two extra points. 13 for fourth place, 11 for fifth, as Marc Márquez, all on his own, starts the last lap here in Brno. A tactical masterclass again from the Spanish rider and his Repsol Honda team. Back on board with Rossi. He won't be close enough to attack Crutchlow at turn number 13. Crutchlow holding firm and doing a great job in fourth place.
Doing a brilliant job. There is Dani Pedrosa, rather lonely second place for Dani Pedrosa. Here's Maverick Viñales in third place. And now the real battle of the race. One lap to go of this magnificent Brno circuit. Rossi closes up once again. If he's going to have a nibble, it's surely going to be down at turn three. This is one. Two's the little left-hand kick. And then they come down to the left and right, the first of the fast S's. Where is Rossi going to be positioned on the track? Bradley Smith has retired.
Can't get close to the turn three. That was the first opportunity. So Crutchlow able to keep Rossi at bay in turn three. This will be the next chance then. Can
down
he get
five,
good drive out
it?
Of four?
Yeah.
Down on the brakes, down in turn five. Crutchlow was wide last time around at turn five. Is Rossi about to pounce now? He's coming up the inside. Rossi has a look up the inside of Crutchlow. And he's got the inside line. Crutchlow tries to hold firm, but Rossi's got the inside line. He will take fourth place. Crucial two World Championship points there for Rossi.
Yeah, when we go to Valencia in November, that pass could be vital. We start talking about World Championship honours. Can Crutchlow come back at him? He certainly is very capable of having to dig back at the nine times World Champion. 8 and 9. Then they're going to plunge down towards the Schwartz corner. Rossi up into fourth place. Vizioso running in sixth place.
Rossi got that Yamaha hooked up brilliantly coming out of turn number 9. No way through for Rossi. Marc Márquez is already doing the celebration wheelies up Horsepower Hill.
Well, this team should celebrate. Did they take a gamble? Was it planned? It doesn't matter. Marc Márquez wins here in an absolutely masterclass of riding and tactics to open up an advantage in the World Championship battle.
His Repsol Honda teammate Dani Pedrosa will come home in second place. Pedrosa then closing the gap on to Viñales, Dovizioso and Rossi in the championship. A lonely second place for Pedrosa. And Maverick Viñales rescuing third place. His first podium finish in four races. Rossi takes fourth just from 2016 winner Cal Crutchlow. Dovizioso sixth. Petrucci over the line in seventh.
Well, a huge... I think sigh of relief in that team. Actually, that was Dani Pedrosa's side of the garage. That was Dani Pedrosa's dad. Boy, I bet they were biting their fingernails in the early part of that race. And well done, Maverick Viñales. Really good ride. There's Roman Fucada, he's a crew chief. Boy, Lorenzo led the race in the early stages when it was in the wet. In the end, finishing with a single World Championship point in 15th place. Behind him, no points for Scott Redding. No points for Rabat or Sam Lowes. Andrea Iannone, Hector Barbera, Bradley Smith retired. Baz and Batista crashed out in separate incidents. Roll on, Austria. What's the weather going to do there? And what are the tactics going to be in Austria?
Yeah, feel a bit for Jorge Lorenzo. I think his day would have been much, much better. He lost a lot of time with his second bike, not quite fully prepped when he came in for the flag-to-flag bike swap. Andrea Dovizioso, of course, he stayed out the longest with Rossi and Zarco. Rossi fourth, Dovizioso sixth. Zarco stayed out another lap, and he ended that race in 12th place. Carol Abraham, who at one stage was fighting for the podium, he dropped back to 13th.
Tell you what, that could have been worse, those World Championship standings at one stage when we realised the masterstroke pulled by Honda and Marquez. We were talking about bigger advantages than that. The chasers, led by Viñales, then Rossi and Dovizioso, have not done such a bad job, and they've made the championship still very interesting indeed.
Yeah, there was a couple of decent damage limitation exercises out there.
Yeah,
Dani Pedrosa, of course, as we told you at the start of the show, 150 career podiums now, only the third rider in history to do so. Valentino Rossi leading the way by a country mile on 225 podiums, but a milestone day for Dani Pedrosa, and certainly good for his championship challenge, because he's only 17 points now behind Maverick Vinales in fifth place and 9 behind Valentino Rossi. Lost a bit of ground, of course, to his teammate Marc Marquez, who's now 31 points clear of Pedrosa.
There's some mighty relief faces there. I am absolutely fascinated, and I don't think we're ever really going to know. They'd probably say it was all planned, weren't they? It was planned. It was a totally brilliant thing to do.
You know what? I'd love to know just how close Marquez was to starting on slicks.
Yeah.
He must have crossed his mind.
But if it was planned, to go out just for two laps on that softer option at a wet weather tyre, test out the conditions, see how it is. Yeah, it's okay for slicks. I'm coming in much earlier than anybody else. Bang, gone. Thank you. 25.
Well, the thing was as well, Nick, if he didn't stay out there, then he was dropping through the field. He knew he was dropping through the field. He didn't go, okay, maybe it will rain, I'm going to stay out and see what happens. He went, no, I'm coming in.
Well, it's a Spanish trio at the front, and a fitting tribute to the late, great Angel Nieto, Marquez Pedrosa and Vinales. Good ride by Cal Crutch. He'd be disappointed that Rossi took him there at the end, but a very hard-earned fifth place by the race winner from last year. But here comes Marc Marquez. I reckon him and his team will be celebrating big style as he comes into pit lane, and rightly so. Brilliant.
Yeah.
Of course, a race is not won on tactics. We never want the sport to be like that, but they did take a gamble, and boy, did that gamble pay off.
Second
Sandy
race.
Sandy, his crew chief, looks more relieved than excited, doesn't he?
Yeah, he didn't have that many grey hairs at the start of the race, Santi. Valentino Rossi then did salvage fourth place at the end of that race. A late move on Cal Crutchlow claimed him two precious World Championship points, but when the post-mortem commences tonight, they will realise that they did not come in at the right time. They stayed out too long, and not the first time we've said that Yamaha and Rossi in a flag-to-flag race have got their tactics a little bit wrong.
Yeah, they are smiling about the weather forecast, aren't they? They are, without a doubt, discussing. Well done, Dani Pedrosa. Lonely, very professional. Another podium finish for Pedrosa. He's right in that championship hunt.
The way it goes for Marc Marquez now, you wouldn't be surprised if it started pouring down with rain, would you?
When they're on the podium, the skies are going to open, aren't they? I think it was calculated, because, boy, they look mighty serious. As you would, but they look mighty serious when he sat there waiting to go, didn't he? And then they made a very, very late decision, didn't they, to put that softer rear wet weather tyre in. Was it a decision they were going to make? Were they thinking about putting the slicks in then? But tactically, a brilliant move. And it certainly threw me and Matt, I can tell you, and I would imagine everybody else. Shaking the hands with Dani Pedrosa.
Well, it's his speed as well, isn't it, when he gets out on those slick tyres. Yeah. You know, the track's going to still be very slick and very greasy, yet he gets the hammer down straight away on the slicks that open up such a big gap. The Vizioso then, surrounded by an army of Ducati technical staff, just debriefing after a sixth place. Another rider who stayed out the longest with Rossi and Zarco. We do know that Ducati were a little bit behind in terms of prepping that second bike. I think Jorge Lorenzo lost about 15 seconds at one stage, which would have put him a lot further up the field.
Yeah, I think they had another wet weather bike ready, didn't they? Rather, well, with the wet weather tyres. Well, a wet weather bike. And consequently, they couldn't come in any earlier. There was no doubt that Honda and Marquez were ready to do exactly what they did.
Well, it's back to the drawing board for Yamaha in many respects. Not for the first time we've said that in terms of flag-to-flag races. They've really got to up their game.
Sete Gibbon out. Rider, coach, mentor, whatever you want to call it, with Dani Pedrosa. Looking very thoughtful, very pleased with the situation. Oh, we have had some amazing races today. And so different, haven't they? I mean, That was a fantastic race, the MotoGP race. Hey, it wasn't the battles that we've seen all season, but it just was so interesting. And then we did have a really good battle at the end there between Rossi and Crutchlow. Here he is, Maverick Vinales, back on the podium. And a smile. We haven't seen too many of them recently.
Well, Maverick, congratulations on the podium here in Brno after quite a crazy race. I think an important podium for you. Tell us, when you switched onto the dry bike, you dropped down to 13th. Did you know you had the pace for a podium?
Well, in the first hours were so difficult because, you know, I tried to make the best, but in the first laps I didn't have a good feeling, so difficult to make the tires get really warm. But after I felt it really good, I think we did a good job. Anyway, after starting 7 and on a bad weekend, going on the podium is a really good result, so we have to work even harder.
All right, thanks a lot, Maverick, congratulations.
Yeah, well done, Maverick Vinales. Keeping in that championship hunt. Back on the podium, his first podium since what? Beginning of June when we were in Mugello. Still second in the world championship.
And like he said, one of his issues when he went out on the slicks was getting heat into the tyres and understanding the grip levels. And that's where Marc Márquez again comes to the fore. He's so strong and quickly adjusting to track conditions as Dani Pedrosa looks like he's about to head over to talk to Dylan. But a great day for Pedrosa, his 150th career podium. Not bad when only Giacomo Agostini and Valentino Rossi have scored more Grand Prix podiums than you.
No, and it's important, he's right in the championship hunt. He's with Dylan.
Well, Danny, congratulations. Second place here in Brno. On paper, we saw you had the pace to really challenge Mark, but of course, the bike change just came too late. Do you almost regret that not coming in earlier?
Well, we know these races are a little bit difficult to know exactly the point. All the day was like stopping and raining and stopping and raining, so it was clear that it was drying up so quick. I didn't imagine that was that fast, but for sure you never know if it's going to drop some spots again, so I was a little bit in between. And for sure I regret one lap, because I decide one lap later. I think I could do one lap earlier, and this was on my plan, but finally I stuck on the line of the group, and yes, I regret that lap, but still for sure very happy with this race. We had a good pace, we were competitive all the weekend, and this is super positive for the team. Fortunately we didn't make perfect race, but was good enough for the podium, and looking forward to keep this momentum.
All right, thanks a lot, Danny, congratulations.
Yeah, been a very good weekend for Dani Pedrosa. Looked strong throughout. Yeah, regrets just one lap. Could have beaten Marc Márquez. Márquez looked in such great form. But as I say, he's right there now in the championship hunt. He is just 33 points behind. 31 points behind his teammate Marc Márquez, who leads the way. And only 9 points down now on Valentino Rossi. In fourth place.
Consolation for Cal Crutchlow was he was a top independent team rider.
And here he is, Marc Márquez. What a day for him and the team. Is he going to spill the beans to Dylan?
Well, Mark, congratulations. A very dominant victory here in Brno. And I'm sure many people on the first lap with that soft option wet thought you were crazy. But you came in, you switched earlier than anyone. Tell us, was that in the plan or was a little bit of luck involved?
Honestly, this morning with the hard rear tire, I didn't feel well. For some reason, it was, I think, a strange tire. But this, you know, I lost all the confidence, and when I go out from the box to the grid, I felt something strange with the heart and say, put this off. But then when we start the race, I realized that was the wrong option. I mean, was spinning too much already on the beginning. But then when I see that was getting dry, I say, okay, this is my time, flag to flag. I will try to attack. And yeah, I go in very, very early because it still was wet, still very difficult. First, second lap, I nearly crashed many, many times, but I stay on the bike, and then I start to push. I take my rhythm, and then, of course, when I saw P1 plus 22, that was another race, I just tried to control the distance. I was able to be faster, but no mean. So very happy because
you know, these kind of races are very, very difficult. But like we see, Dani, Vinales, Rossi are there, Dovizioso also. So this championship will be long, will be hard, but we take these 25 points, very important.
Oh, yeah, thanks a lot, Mark. Congratulations.
Was it planned or not? We don't really know. Actually, the way he was talking there, perhaps that it wasn't planned. This was the move after just two laps. And it was an absolute masterstroke.
But he always backs himself, does he, Mark Marquez? He's full of self-belief, has the courage of his convictions to, you know, start the race on that soft option rear tyre. Didn't feel good on the medium this morning. And then when he knew he was in big trouble, straight away, he didn't just try and hang in there and see if it rained. He had the courage of his convictions to come into the pitch, change to his slick tyre bike, and then go out, still with the track a little bit sketchy in parts, and just get the hammer down to make sure that nobody was ever going to get anywhere near him. It's a victory for strategy and bravery in many respects.
Yeah. He's a highly intelligent motorcycle racer. And and he backs his own decisions, and that's exactly what he did. And there is no doubt the others came in too late, but here we are sitting here watching it. We just could not believe how fast the track was drying out, could we? Hindsight, once again, it's a very, very easy thing.
Yeah, questions to be asked at Yamaha, questions certainly to be asked at Ducati as well. I mean, not having Dovizioso and Lorenzo's bikes ready for them to come in, that's not a great call, is it, by Ducati, to be honest?
No, it's not. Obviously, they felt the weather forecast was different, and they had a different wet weather tyre bike ready. But once Marquez had come in, boy, they must have realised that the situation was changing dramatically. So here comes Marc Marquez, the walk to the podium here in Brno. It's his third win at this circuit, the second in MotoGP, one Moto2 win. And he has opened up a 14-point lead in the World Championship over Maverick Viñales. Round 10 of the championship. The one lap, you would have never believed this would have been the situation. And he would hold such a big advantage. Advantage of, 12 and a half seconds. And he slowed considerably towards the end over his teammate, Dani Pedrosa. Maverick Viñales chats away with Dani Pedrosa. Back on the podium on that factory Yamaha bike. So onto the podium they come. First it's Maverick Viñales, first podium since Mugello at the beginning of June. And second place, Dani Pedrosa. But the race winner, his third win here at Brno, his third win this season. He increases his lead in the World Championship. It's Marc Marquez. So congratulations to the Repsol Honda team. It's the man who did the weather forecast, I think, for the team. They're in great spirits. Not too much celebrating tonight. Big, big test here tomorrow for all the MotoGP teams. And then it's on the road immediately. 4-hour journey to the Red Bull Ring in Austria for round 11 of the championship next Sunday. Third place to Maverick Viñales. Looked very, very much happier than of late. Second of the championship, 14 points down on Marquez. Dani Pedrosa in second place. Dani Pedrosa still fifth in the championship, but only 9 points down now on Valentino Rossi in fourth place. But it was a technical masterclass off the track, decision on tyres, and then when it comes to putting the bike where it matters, Marc Marquez once again. He wins here in Brno, his third win of the season, his third at this track in the Czech Republic, and he leads the championship by 14 points going into the next round in Austria. three Spanish riders on the podium here in Brno. A fitting tribute to the late, great Ángel Nieto. And the bottles of cava will be given out, but they will not be opened in respect of the 13 times world champion who lost his life on Thursday. So a great day for the